Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's learn about the hydrohalogenation reaction, which is the electrophilic addition of a hydrogen and a halogen across a carbon-carbon pi bond. To do a hydrohalogenation, we need an alkene, like the one shown in the upper left, and one of the strong halogen acids, HCl, HBr, or HI. HF is not acidic enough and does not work. We'll focus on HBr, but all the acids behave the same way. We know that HBr is a strong acid. Acids react with electron-rich molecules, and a carbon-carbon pi bond is weakly electron-rich. The high acidity of HBr coaxes the carbon-carbon pi bond to break and attack the hydrogen atom. The HBr bond breaks with the electrons going to Br. The result is this mechanistic step. And formation of a new carbocation intermediate. Let's put our new hydrogen in a box so we can keep track of it. What happens to carbocations? They are either attacked or they lose a beta hydrogen. We get attack if we have a nucleophile, even a weak one. Bromide or chloride or iodide are all nucleophiles that will attack a carbocation. So we finish our reaction by attacking our carbocation. Our final product reflects the addition of a hydrogen and a bromine, a halogen, across the carbon-carbon pi bond. A hydrohalogenation, specifically here, a hydrobromination. Let's look at our three factors: regiochemistry, stereochemistry, and oxidation reduction. For regiochemistry, we could have drawn this reaction differently. We could have protonated our alkene so that the hydrogen went on the more highly substituted carbon, and the carbocation was on the other carbon. There's our new hydrogen. And our carbocation. This would give us a different carbocation and a different hydrohalogenation product. Here is our product. A different regioisomer. Why is it different? Well, as it turns out, it has to do with carbocation stability. The top reaction forms a secondary carbocation, while the bottom makes a primary. Secondary is more stable. So when doing a hydrohalogenation, protonate the alkene so that the reaction goes through the more stable carbocation. The product that forms from the more stable carbocation is called the Markovnikov product. Markovnikov product. The unobserved regioisomer is called the anti-Markovnikov product. How about stereochemistry? Is this a syn or anti-addition? As it turns out, it's neither. Let's look at a different alkene, a cyclic alkene. We'll use HCl this time. Let's assume the hydrogen comes in from the top face. We'll form a new carbocation. The chloride will then attack our flat sp2 hybridized carbon. It can attack from the top face with the chlorine being up. Whoops. Or from the bottom face with the chlorine being down and the methyl up. As it turns out, there is no preference, and we'll get a 50-50 mix of the H and Cl being either cis or syn product or trans, which is the anti product. How about redox? As it turns out, this is neither an oxidation or reduction. One added atom, the hydrogen, is less electronegative than carbon. The other added atom, a halogen, chlorine, if we use the reaction on the left, is more electronegative. Therefore, to a simple approximation, the net redox effect is zero. So the hydrohalogenation is an addition reaction that goes through a carbocation and favors the Markovnikov product. It is neither syn nor anti, or an oxidation or reduction.